Have you ever wondered how computers and robots see? How self-driving cars know how to stay on the road safely? Or how medical imaging creates 3D models and views your body? How your favorite 3D games achieve super realistic lighting effects? Or simply how your smartphone magically blurs out the background in your portrait mode photos? Well, there's one secret ingredient that ties all of these things together. The depth map. Don't know what that is? Great. This video is going to go over what a depth map is, and how and why they're secretly everywhere, and how you can use them. But before that, welcome to Looking Glasses YouTube channel. Here, we talk about our 3D holographic displays, 3D technologies, and all the ways in which we can understand and create innovative 3D canvases for experiences, artwork, games, connection, and more. If you're into this content, please like and subscribe, and we'll know to make more just like it. Okay, first things first. What is a depth map? Depth maps are like the secret ingredient that adds that extra dimension to our virtual experiences. They contain information about the distances of objects from a specific perspective or reference point, like a camera lens as an example. Each pixel is assigned a value to represent the distance of that pixel from the reference point, which creates a 3D representation of the scene for its RGB image or virtual scene. Just take a look at this depth map of the Stanford Bunny. The white pixels represent the part of the scene that is closest to the camera lens, while the black pixels represent the part of the scene that is furthest. In this case, the part of the scene that's closest are the ears of the bunny, and since it's a top-down shot, the furthest away is the tail. Just a quick note, sometimes this can be reversed, and depth maps aren't only black and white. They can also have an RGB spectrum instead. So why is this important? Check out this image I took of my friend hiking in the Grand Canyon. Humans naturally perceive depth thanks to our stereoscopic vision. So it's easy for us to understand that there's a path that extends close to us, then there's a person, and then further away are some more people in front of a beautiful view of the landscape that goes off infinitely. But for computers, it's a different story. Software can't just intuit from a bunch of different colored pixels where the pixels were in relation to each other when the image was taken or rendered in 3D. For all the computer knows, you took a picture of a painting on a wall and it's all just flat. That's where depth maps come in. Like we saw in the Stanford Bunny example, each pixel is assigned a value based on its distance from the camera so that software can also understand the depth of the scene. I like to think of it like we're at the beginning of computer depth vision. So it's like how Agent Smith's great-grandfather saw the Matrix before, you know, it got much better. Okay, enough with the bad jokes. All of this still raises the question of real-world application of depth maps. So to answer that, let's go into some practical use cases for depth maps that affect, well, everyone. Starting with 3D games. 3D games are only getting more and more realistic, and one of the reasons why is because of depth maps. You can check out Doom from 1993. For the time, it was immersive and groundbreaking, but realism in video games, especially in first-person shooters, where you are the game character, is and has increased drastically by making it similar to how human beings see, with depth of field, blur, crisper detail, and brighter colors close up, and hazier detail, dimmer colors further away. Titles like Grand Theft Auto 5 or Fortnite blow our minds with their lifelike lighting and shadows, thanks to depth map information. You can also find depth maps in medical imaging. Have you ever actually wondered how doctors create 3D models of our insides? A depth map is rendered by taking multiple 2D images or slices of the human body from CT or MRI scans and calculating the distance from each pixel to the camera through software. Depth maps are the eyes of autonomous cars and robots too. LiDAR, stereo cameras, and depth sensors join forces to help them navigate and interact with the world. Self-driving cars and robots can detect other objects and their distances from the car and the robot. Like maybe other robots, people, cars, poles, etc. Essentially, they can see the world. And good thing too, because otherwise, how are the self-driving cars not driving into things? So how does this apply to me and you? Well, if you've used portrait mode on your smartphone, you've most likely used depth maps already. Phones these days have dual camera setups or depth sensing cameras that capture images from slightly different perspectives, allowing the device to calculate the distance to various objects in the scene. Your phone uses depth maps to allow you to play with settings like depth of field blur and change the focus of the image even after capture from the depth maps, which adds a nice effect, like looks professional. Speaking of photos, have you ever uploaded a 3D image on Facebook or seen one on your feed? That parallax effect is created from using the depth map to simulate the 3D environment the photo was taken in. There are also apps like Focus, Depth Cam, and Record 3D, which allow you to add depth maps to photos you've already captured with AI, capture a live photo or video with depth maps, see the footage in 3D on your phone. Record 3D actually has a Looking Glass export option that allows you to pull RGBD video taken from the app straight into Looking Glass Studio to view it in 3D, which is a great segue to image to hologram. Looking Glass Blocks has a new software that allows you to take any 2D image and view it in 3D as a block or as a hologram on the Looking Glass. If you don't know what Blocks is already, it's a platform that allows you to share 3D and embed 3D media to view on the web, on your headsets, phones, and on your Looking Glass display. Image to hologram works like this. It uses AI to create a depth map for any 2D image, then creates a mesh for the RGB part of the image using the depth information, before stretching that mesh to be viewable in real 3D. This means you can take any 2D image you captured or created using Midjourney or rendered out of Blender or however you create and see it in 3D immediately. And that about wraps it up. You learned what a depth map is, what depth maps are used for, how you can use and maybe already use depth maps every day. If you enjoyed learning about one of 3D's best kept secrets, please like this video and subscribe to this channel, and we can keep giving you more content just like this. And if you use depth maps, let us know in the comments what you're doing. Until next time.